only dog to ever make People Magazine's best dress list?
Sally Jesse Raphael.
What's the very last thing you said to your wife during a Whoopi session that had absolutely nothing to do with Whoopi?
Wake up.
Name a piece of clothing wives buy for their husbands.
Halter tops.
That girl at the party must have been a train conductor. All night she kept saying,
all aboard.
I'm Bob Eubanks, and welcome to the most outrageous game show moments 5. Can you believe we're back again? Now, remember, in our last special, we showed you still more of the funniest and most memorable moments that have ever occurred during game show competition. Hey, but trust me, when I tell you that tonight we've outdone ourselves, we really have. We've got a brand new hour of outrageous game show moments that are so funny, you've just got to see them to believe them. And here once again to help me bring them to you is another game show legend. He's hosted countless classic game shows, including Love Connection, Scrabble, and Lingo, and many others. It's my privilege to bring on my buddy, Mr. Chuck Woolery. Chuck, how are you, buddy?
I'm fine. Thanks for having me with you.
Oh, we're going to have fun.
You know, I've certainly heard more than my share of wild and outrageous answers over the years, but the moments that we've pulled together tonight really are in a class by themselves.
You're right.
In fact, we found so many hilarious moments, it's almost impossible just to jam them all into one show.
And believe me, if that wasn't enough, we're also going to play a few more games with the folks right around here, too.
So, strap yourself in, because the next hour of outrageous moments will have you laughing harder than you ever have before.
All right, tell you what, let's get things started right now with a journey inside the minds of some very confused game show contestants. Let me tell you about these folks. Here are some folks who look intelligent, They sound intelligent, But believe me, the answers that come out of their mouths, not so intelligent.
Yeah.
Name an occupation in which you disguise your appearance.
A doctor.
Gentlemen, how will your wife complete this sentence? First thing in the morning, I usually find my husband's blank on my what?
I'll probably find my teeth on her sink.
Name something London is famous for.
I'm thinking pastas.
Famous London pasta.
Tell me the slang word for money.
Money.
What about your daddy? What does he do?
He sells cookies.
Cookies? To whom?
To the movie theaters.
Anybody
and
else?
Fat people.
And fat people.
Number one, it says here that you operate a multiple spindle automatic screw machine. What do you make?
$2.68 an hour.
Huh?
$2.68 an hour.
Name a kind of bear. Harmon.
Papa bear.
A papa bear, of course. Show me a papa bear. You're doing good work.
Ladies, how will your husband say you would complete this sentence? I don't know why, but my husband acts really weird whenever I try to touch his what? Stephanie.
His bonkers.
There are some street names common to cities all over the U.S. Name one.
Hollywood Boulevard.
Hollywood Boulevard.
Something usually done only once a week.
Make love.
Name an animal whose eggs you'd probably never eat for breakfast.
Hamster.
Hamster. I hate to tell you, but
You know, those little pellets aren't eggs.
What's the one thing you would hate to hear your wife say about your last girlfriend on Coast to Coast television? She said your last girlfriend was a hooker.
Oh,
never had that answer before.
Name a day of the year when you really want to be with friends.
December. Something you'd find in an operating room. You said, operator. Well, someone's got to operate.
Name something that your wife would do that would be shocking.
Greet you at the door naked.
What do you think it is that makes some game show contestants give such off-the-wall answers? I mean, you turn on the cameras, some people just fall apart. You think it's the light, the cameras, or the studio itself? What do you think it is?
I really don't know. It beats me. Whatever it is, though, it's not limited to just the studio. In fact, you know what we did? We took our cameras around here, and we asked everyday people some of the simplest questions we could come up with.
This is not going to be pretty, is it?
Afraid not.
What does it mean if you're monogamous?
You like Monopoly a lot?
Monopoly is your game.
What does it mean if you're monogamous?
You can use both hands at the same time.
What were people not allowed to do during Prohibition?
Sleep with each other?
What were people not allowed to do during Prohibition?
Go on strike, I don't know.
In what year did Christopher Columbus discover America?
In 1864.
Are you sure?
No.
In what year did Christopher Columbus discover America?
Zero? I don't know.
Now think about this.
1,000. I don't know.
In the movie Love Story, love means never having to say what?
Go on a diet.
Those answers were just plain awful. It makes you wonder if they possibly could get any worse. Well, wonder no more.
Tell me a food that comes in instant form.
Asparagus.
Name something you wouldn't want the police to find in the trunk of your car.
Pickles.
All that brine.
Gentlemen, what is your favorite thing to masticate? Tom?
Masticate. The dog.
The dog.
Give me a slang name for policeman.
Dick.
What did you say?
Dick.
Okay. See what he said!
And something twins might share while growing up.
You know, I can't help but think that they both feed from the same place, so I would say a mother's breast.
While growing up. Right. They're 25. Hey, Mike, are you still with Mom?
Name a state that begins with the letter M.
Mexico.
Only dog to ever make People magazine's best dressed list.
Sally Jesse Raphael.
Gentlemen, what is the last thing you commemorated, Robert?
The doctor took Shannon off pills because they're messing up her system, so. we don't want to have any kids.
Uh-huh.
So once a month, we commemorate.
At a recent hearing, opponents of fluoridated water argued that too much fluorine in a person's system can cause an uncontrollable desire for sex.
call like a man.
Name something couples do to spark up their marriage.
How about get together with other couples?
What do you mean?
What do I mean? I just mean that, not talk.
Well, Bob, when we come back, we're going to see what happens when contestants open their mouths and all the family secrets come flying out. Oh, boy. Stick around. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the most outrageous game show, Moments 5. You know, one of the most amazing things that I've learned as a game show host is how open people are about their personal lives, even when the whole world is watching. You know, some people don't give you just a little information. You get the whole download, if you know what I mean. Check out these folks whose mouths definitely runneth over.
How long did your very first kiss as husband and wife last?
It better be 5 seconds.
5 seconds. She said it lasted 45 seconds.
45 seconds? That was my brother.
How you doing?
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
What's your story?
Well, I'm in young girls' pants. I manufacture pants.
I'm a young girl.
Obed, scariest thing about being in a relationship?
I think it'll be trying to figure out exactly when it's okay to fart in front of them.
That's when you know it's love.
You could have gone to her room for room service.
Yeah.
But you didn't take up the offer, Chuck. Now, why is that?
Well, no, there's no more ink left in my pen.
Gentlemen, what's the very last thing you said to your wife during a whoopee session that had absolutely nothing to do with whoopee?
Wake up.
You're going to need the number 45. Who has 45 in their right hand?
I have red balls, Chuck. It's going to her.
Okay, going to you. Here we go. I wouldn't touch that line with a forklift.
Because you're very attracted to the person. Because he's your husband. Because
why you marry someone?
Because it's your wedding night. Because you're horny as hell.
Why you make love to someone?
Gentlemen, how will your wife say you would complete this sentence the next time my wife leaves her blank on my what? I'm going to toss that sucker out a window.
Her dress.
On your?
Body. Because I try on the dresses all the time.
I beg your pardon?
You know, just for fun.
Oh, of course, yeah. All you guys do that just for fun, yeah. Does he do this often?
Often.
Really? You put the lingerie on too?
Oh, yeah!
He puts it on!
Oh, yeah! Yes! Oh, God! Yeah.
You know, Chuck, a lot of people think that just because hosts like you and me don't have to answer any questions, we've got it easy. But hosting isn't always as simple as it looks. Boy, that's the truth. I know we appear to be calm and cool and have everything under control, but you know the trick, Bob. Most of our nightmares usually end up on the cutting room floor, and if anyone ever gathered those moments together, you'd see how funny it is when good hosts go bad. Guess what, my friend? They've gathered them together.
I was afraid you were going to say that.
It's not pretty.
Hi, David.
Hey, how are you?
I'm very well. Nice of you to inquire.
Hey,
and how's your dog?
Lucy's doing awesome.
Good.
She says hello.
Give her yeah, liquor for me. Nice to have you. I don't think I've ever said that to a contestant. Yeah. I'll be fine.
Time is up, ladies. I mean,
Welcome to Bullseye. It's a very interesting description Charlie just made there. I play a little golf myself. How's the game these days?
Well, I'm real straight, but not real long.
Well, we all have our problems. I'm real long, but I'm not very straight. How about you?
How are you?
Wonderful.
The braces are off, Natalie.
The braces?
Yeah, didn't you have braces?
That was yesterday, Chuck.
Sorry, Natalie, it must have been yesterday.
It's fourth and final clue, Ken.
Hot.
Red.
Well, all I could think of was royal...
Flesh.
Yeah, but that's where you were wrong. Now what?
Oh, no.
What?
No,
we...
Not again. Don't tell me. You mean to tell me that royal was the answer to the puzzle? Let's see it. Okay, I give up.
Let's count up our squares now. Brianna, you have two, which gives you $1,000, and our thanks for being here on Hollywood Squares. Nice to meet you. Thanks a lot. You look stunned. I know. And Alan, you've added three squares to your total. That gives you... hold on. Where are we?
Annie, I believe...
Oh, she won! Nomination shot the right now.
All right, cover the kids' ears, because when we come back, we'll see what happens when things get slightly raunchy on game shows.
Oh, come on, Chuck. Do we always have to show the dirty clips?
Well, Bob, it's not my fault. Most of them are from your shows. We'll be right back.
I mean, Love Connection wasn't Mary Poppins.
It wasn't?
No.
Welcome back to the Most Outrageous Game Show Moments 5. Hey, I got a little trivia question for you. Why don't you take a look at this old high school yearbook photograph and see if you can guess who it is. I mean, look at the hair on that kid. Give up? You're right. It's none other than yours truly, Bob Eubanks, from Pasadena High School way back in 19... No, I'm not going to tell you. Now that you know the drill, do you think you can recognize some other high school yearbook photographs of classic game show hosts? Well, just for fun, we showed people here some high school photos of several hosts to see if they could figure out who they were. Now I want you to take a look, and as you do, see if you can figure it out before they do.
Oh, I know who that is. That's Mickey Rourke.
That's Howdy Doody.
I think that's Pat Sajak.
I think it's Ross Perot.
Pee Wee Herman. Dean Martin. That is Ben Stein from When Ben Stein's Money. Alfalfa from The Little Rascals.
That's Stephanie Jack Nicholson.
Engelbert Humperdinck.
That is Gene Rayburn from The Match Game.
You know, one thing that always amazed me on Love Connection was how I could ask someone a completely innocent question only to get back an answer so explicit it would almost make my eyes pop out of my head. Sometimes it seems like no matter how hard you try, you just can't keep things from getting a little down and dirty. Watch this.
Actually has a species of animal name for him. What kind of animal is it?
It's probably the crab. I'm just saying, if you spend any time in the grotto, you know what I'm talking about.
Next question, gentlemen. What was the most infantile suggestion you made to your wife on your first date, Joe?
Why don't you eat something?
All right. Patty says the most infantile suggestion was that she shouldn't be so closed-minded.
I should be looser, you know.
You were loose enough that night.
Don't.
Norman said to Fred, that girl at the party must have been a train conductor. All night she kept saying,
all aboard. Danny's outlook on friends is very jaded. He once told a nerdy friend that they would become pals only if he gave a bath to a dead squirrel. Hey, Danny, I'll let you be my friend if you give this beaver a bath. I'm an Oregon State fan, okay?
Before we play our game, let's let our home audience see this gentleman's famous name. Joan Alexander, would you start, please?
Is this something that I might use?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Would I enjoy using it?
Very much.
Could I ever use this in my work?
I think that, yes, there might be an occasion for you to use this in your work.
Then, well, would I generally use this in front of an audience?
I don't think so. No.
Is it possible that if I gave a party...
Johnny, the answer is no.
Robbie the Robot said the guy who made me got a lot of parts from a toy store. For example, my eyes are made from marbles, and my blank is a slinky.
Wiener.
My wiener. Show me the plugged-in answer.
Okay, my Johnson.
Yeah, that's a match.
There you go. My leader. My family.
You got it.
What specific warning would you most like to give to another couple just before they made whoopee in your first romance spot? Sandra?
Look out for the stick shift.
After a woodpecker pecks a hole in a tree, is it unusual for him to put something in that little hole? Yes or no?
You're on your own.
Does he put something in the hole?
Yes or no?
I would have to say yes. He probably puts his beak in there.
He said he put something in there.
After he gets through making the hole?
Well, it's hard to put something in something that there's no hole there. No. Lord knows we won't try.
You know, one of the things that makes a game show so exciting is the heat of the competition. Now, unfortunately, that competition can get too heated at times. Every once in a while, tempers flare, and the action gets a little too hot to handle. Now, when that happens, stand back, because it's every host and contestant for himself. You don't believe me? Then you take a look at this.
Colton, tell us what you do again.
Financial advisor.
You tell people what to do with their money?
Absolutely.
How old are you, Colton?
25.
Colton, you look like you should be in the Backstreet Boys or NSYNC, not telling people what to do with their money.
You look like you should be in Star Wars.
I am your Darth Vader. You're Princess Leia, punk. Pretty good.
All right, one more.
I haven't tried Betty yet.
I've tried Betty.
So either you are taking home that $1,600, or your friend Julian here is taking everything. You went foul! We actually have to beat that because we can't play it on TV. Are you disappointed, Jeff?
Yeah, man.
You know?
Dude, I trusted you.
Thank you, Quentin Tarantino.
I'm not going to say. I'm going to keep saying until I calm down.
Well, thank you for joining us. Where knowledge can make you money, money can make you a friend or foe. Skippy.
I'm going to be at the Improv in Las Vegas.
What on earth would you be doing there?
I'm into dominating women. If I could just hear you say, "Who's your mommy?" Just once.
Sclerotherapy is a treatment for what medical malady?
And I know this one, but I don't think Jennifer does.
I'm gonna have to say diabetes.
Is it diabetes? That is incorrect. The answer is varicose veins. She got you. You lose all of your money.
I don't have varicose veins yet. I mean, that's why Karen knew it.
Oh. This may be a lot more fun than we anticipated.
You don't like to cook.
She can't cook. No, let's clarify that.
Okay.
She can't cook.
And I need to cook there.
You do not know how to cook. No, let's rephrase that.
You do not know how to cook. I don't know how to cook, and I can tell anybody that I don't know how to cook.
Add a little sugar to your rice, and we got instant gummy bears.
You don't like
I tried to teach it, but it's no good.
Why didn't you want to do it?
I didn't think it'd be too exciting laying there doing it in the mud.
Yeah.
You know.
When in the hell did he make a pass at me? Never made one pass.
I have to stop and
tell that's the first date I've been on in my life that a man didn't make a pass at me.
Well,
at my age.
I must stop and tell my audience now that I am completely over my head. I want you to know.
I'm sure you are. You never made.
When we come back, we're going to check out the steamier side of game shows when hosts and contestants get a little too friendly, if you know what I mean. How come nothing like that ever happens to me? How come? Back to the most outrageous game show moments. You know, we've seen some wild stuff so far, but just take a look at these outrageous moments.
In fine fashion.
Bergeron, I don't believe this place. It's all new.
Yeah.
It's a new set, a new logo. You've got a brand new beach in the center square. I got one question, though.
What?
Why the hell are you still here? Whose leg did you hump to keep this job?
How long have you known George here?
7 years.
Yeah, now you are signing, I notice, and what does that tell us?
That means he's deaf.
If you hit a high note, will this glass break?
No.
Time, Juliana, just give him a spin.
I love you, my darling.
10, 16, you did it. We'll wait. Will somebody tell my wife I'm not gonna be home for dinner? One. I got a $500 bill. I got 160. Is that on there? $160. Hold it up. I want my money back.
You know, Now, Chuck, you and I both know when you host a game show, you meet a lot of nice people. Mm-hmm. And sometimes the contestants just shower you with affection.
This is true. You know, when I was doing Love Connection, if you ever watched when I opened up and I introduced a woman and they would come out, I would always take both hands and put them out like this, and I'd walk backwards to the couch, never looking behind me, watching them all the time. But if a really cute girl came out, I would just kind of stand there and wait for her to jump on me, but sometimes they didn't do it when I was single anyway.
A little backstage story from Love Connection.
Well, you just never know when a little friendly affection is going to go from lukewarm to red hot, Bob. Take a look at these folks. They got lucky whether they were ready for it or not.
Why are you looking so solemn?
I was trying to think of an answer.
Oh, okay. I've forgotten the question.
And here's a young lady over here. Would you stand, please? Let's make a deal. A very simple one. I'll give you $5 for a kiss. How's that?
Oh, you can keep the money. I'll take the kiss.
Yeah.
I'd like to ask you why just the new girls on the block get the kiss. I'm a new girl. How come I don't get one?
Oh. That's one thing you forgot to tell us about you. Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
No. This is gonna be a straight kiss. No fancy stuff, not that. All right. You're not going to faint or anything.
Oh, God, no.
All right.
I'm sorry. I'm Hildegard Travens. I'm from Germany. And I'm actually here to touch your body. But let me touch your body. Let me touch your body.
I'm the easiest host in town.
The challenge is called the Santana Fan. Hello, darling. Thank you. Thank you.
Come
here. So rude. Is that? Thank you, darling. Oh, I tell you honestly, we've been on the air, I think, a year and a half. That's right. The first time on those introductions I've ever gotten aroused.
Show. Thank you. Thank you and welcome to whatever the name of this show is. I've had a wonderful time. I certainly hope you have. That was very nice. It's nice to meet you. I don't even know your name, and somehow I feel I know you already.
When we come back, it's time for the best of the worst.
Oh, boy.
That's right. We're going to show you some of the dumbest game show answers of all time. So don't go away. We're going to come back. 2 and 2. Check out this game show classic, Bob.
What is that?
That is the actual microphone that Gene Rayburn used on all those classic episodes of The Match Game.
You know, what I was thinking about, though, it's impossible to count all of the dumb answers that Gene gathered with that microphone over the years.
You mean dumb answers like this next batch?
Unfortunately, that's exactly what I mean.
Take a look.
Name a piece of clothing wives buy for their husbands.
Halter tops.
Gentlemen, tell me, what is your favorite pasta?
Flat on my stomach, looking at the TV screen.
No.
Name of winter month.
September.
The law of what organization ends by stating that its members are brave, clean, and reverent?
Alcoholics Anonymous.
Boy Scouts.
Okay, then fingers on your buzzers. Who has recently released a biography named Somebody Someday? Just ask another question. Which hell-raising British band recently celebrated their 10th anniversary? What's the first letter of the alphabet?
The name's something a husband asked his wife to carry for him in her purse.
Sunglasses.
Sunglasses.
Condoms.
We're married, but would you mind carrying my condoms?
Gentlemen, what is the very last traditional Jewish favorite your wife prepared for you?
I haven't been Jewish in a long time.
Jewish?
Hurry with your answer.
Chow mein.
Chow mein! Yes.
Corn.
Corn. Okay, he said that it's just the top card, Rick, is really all I need this time, I think, is a bagels, he said.
Bagels?
Yes.
What are bagels?
You can go ahead and tell her, Rick, what are bagels?
I don't know, I'm Mormon.
Is Billy Graham considered to be a good dresser?
No, but he's a terrific end table.
Name a real person who made a living scaring people.
Red Skeleton?
That's brilliant. The dreaded Red Skeleton!
Bachelor number three. If you were to choose a girl in the same way that you would a stereo system, what would you look for?
I would go out and find a 300-watt receiver.
Name a sport husbands and wives can play together. You said kickball. You know, you're not usually married in third grade.
We surveyed 180-year-old men, and we asked them, do you think that rock star Madonna is sexy? Maury, what do you think?
I've seen maybe a couple of times. Yeah. I don't even know what he does. Does he sing or dance or whatever? If I don't think he's sexy, I don't think a lot of men do.
Maury, go to the record store, pick up an album, check it out.
Now don't go away, because when we come back, it's time for the Outrageous Game Show Moments Hall of Fame. Ah, but first, we got a little trivia question for you. Take a look at this photo over here. Can you guess the identity of this legendary game show host? Let me give you a little hint. Before hosting game shows, he was a rock and roll singer who had a top 40 hit. Got any ideas? You have any ideas?
No, but he's a good-looking devil, isn't he?
Yeah, looks like Brian Wilson, the Beach Boy. We'll tell you who it was when we return. You this picture, and we ask you if you could identify the famous celebrity. Figure out who it was? You're gonna be surprised. None other than my buddy Chuck Woolery.
That was me.
You.
Yeah.
I didn't know you were a singer before you were a host.
Actually, I was. It was a song called Naturally Stone that I wrote, and it was 1968 that hit the top 40.
Oh my gosh.
Well, as if that wasn't enough, we've actually saved the best for last.
You got it right, Chuck. Each time that we bring you another installment of the most outrageous game show moments, we are bombarded with requests from viewers asking us to replay their favorite clips from the past shows.
And that's why we've created this special segment we call the Most Outrageous Game Show Moments Hall of Fame.
So here they are, folks, the outrageous classics that you ask for. Most of the electricity in our home flows from the blank to the what?
From the plug to the vibrator.
Oh!
name an article of clothing that children are always losing.
Their pants.
The price of a dozen roses.
$1.75.
Besides a bird, something in a bird cage.
Hamster.
Make a note of this show.
Number two, one of my worst subjects is spelling. Could you tell me, how do you spell relief?
F-A-R-T.
What will your husband say is his favorite condiment?
Oh, I would say his pool table upstairs, definitely.
Annette?
I never heard that word before neither, so I said karate school.
Japanese brides used to shave something off at the time of their marriage. What?
Shave something off at the time of their marriage?
Traditionally.
It must be hair on some part of the body. I wonder where it could be. On the whole, I would say...
People, your time starts now.
A group of pill pushers?
The end of another great show, folks. I want to thank my good buddy Chuck Woolery. It's been fun, Chuck.
Thanks, Bob. It's always great working with you.
We had such a good time. And we're going to see you next time for another installment of the most outrageous game show moments. Thanks for playing, everyone, and good night.
Night, everybody.
NBC Wednesday in 2 weeks. It's the ultimate talent search. Here, you must be the best singer, the best dancer, and have undeniable star power. All I got what it takes. Then you have one shot at... Forever. 24 of the best. America votes. Only one will walk the path to fame. Fame. NBC Wednesdays in 2 weeks. Forever.